Okay, welcome to another edition of the Royal Ramblings. This is the King, aka Iron Man, and I'm standing here now with Spider-Man, and we are at a Halloween party. It looks really cool around here. Check this out. Got a lot of people here having fun for Halloween. A lot of costumes. Here comes Mario and Luigi. Look at that dude, Mario and Luigi. See them? The Mario brothers, both of them now. All right, we're having a Halloween food, and I got blood on my plate. What do you have to say about the blood on my plate?
You have a pink camera.
Yes, I have a pink camera. What do you have to say about the blood on my plate? Watch, I'm gonna eat it. Blood, see? Ow. You got it. You're on the Royal Ramblings. What do you have to say? That's what most people say about the Royal Ramblings. You got it on target.
Every night we hear that.
Every night, Monster Mash. All right, so we're here having our Halloween meal with Spider-Man. And what do you have to say?
It's awesome. I like it.
Yeah. Next time, say it. Don't spray it.
We should do this every single night.
Yeah. Well, that's what we plan to do. Guys, don't forget, Spider-Man and Iron Man, the Iron Web. Soon we're going to be doing kids' parties. We're available for, you know, even if you want us to come to, like, your business meeting. Yeah, we're there. Hold on. All right. Supergirl. Awesome. Welcome to the Royal Ramblings. You're on the Royal Ramblings right now. We're doing the Halloween episode. What do you have to say?
I'm so buff, this doesn't even fit.
All right, so a little bit over-exaggerating, but yeah, a nice suit nonetheless.
Better than the reason yours doesn't fit.
I think that is a better reason than the reason why. Yeah, because I'm Tony Dork, the fat Iron Man. So, what's that?
Oh, well, at least you have one something.
Yeah, but I don't have the belt.
What do you mean? What happened to the belt?
I left it in the house. Well, you know, Spider-Man doesn't have a belt.
Oh, Spider-Man left his belt in the house. Right, but yeah. Hey, check it out. Here's Supergirl.
Supergirl! There you go.
All right, get your camera. Get some show. All right. He's so excited.
Where's his wife?
She didn't want to come anymore.
Naturally.
Okay.
Yeah, just whatever. It doesn't matter what we're doing. All right. So we just took some pictures.
Video of you guys videoing each other.
All right, we're gonna go to Antonio Restivo's Halloween party. And there's gonna be all kinds of footage for that. Stay tuned on the Royal Ramblings coming up. We got Spider-Man here, he's the man.
Stay tuned for the Spider-Man. There's a new episode coming up.
Right now you're getting exclusive footage of the Spider-Man show on Ryan's. And now you're getting footage across here of the Royal Ramblings.
Royal Ramblings.
So getting confusing.
Yeah, with a special appearance of Supergirl. Yeah. We hopefully soon in the future she's gonna go show up on the Fremont Experience too.
Oh. There'll be some real fights if that happens.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Here you go.
All right,
so here we go.
Here
Let's
we go.
Go.
And ready to rock.
All right,
ready
perfect.
To rock.
Okay,
yeah.
All right, check it out. I'm videoing.
Oh.
It's Wonder Woman. She's joined the
Whoa.
Cast.
Chug-a-lug.
All right, you're going on YouTube, Katie, so say something interesting.
I don't fly or anything, but, you know.
Yeah. Awesome. All right, it looks like a haunted house in here. Check it out. Creepy. Trying to follow Wonder Woman. I don't know where she's gone. All the stars on her shorts. They're glowing in the dark. I see you. Yep. So awesome. Check it out. Awesome.
Oh, what is that? Like, ooh, I'm gonna get me some of that.
Very cool. In some very crazy ways. Very cool.
I don't have anything to write that on.
Very nice, dude. Check it out.
Yeah. All right.
All right. Very cool.
Where's our host? Anyone?
I don't think so.
We're looking for our host. And not right here? I don't know. Okay, here we go. Spider-Man, what do you think of this party at Antonio's?
It's very awesome, man. A lot of freaky stuff, and it's really awesome. I'm really having fun right now.
Yeah, and you're eating again.
And I'm eating again, yeah. I keep saying I'm on the diet, but here I am.
Yeah.
Nachos.
Look at you guys. You guys got the plate. Oh my God, pizza.
What are you gonna do?
What am I gonna do?
Gonna eat again?
I'm gonna go get pizza so I can get even more of a bigger iron gut.
Very bizarre.
Oh, there's Terry again. There's Terry again. There she is. Hey, there's Ryan Spider-Man and the DJ equipment. So it's like a DJ Delio reunion.
Yo, what's in the house and I'm back with you. It's crack and this not a crap. But did your Xbox will bring the house back, yo. Bring the noise, all the people out there. Don't waste your time sitting down that chair. Get up now before your ass get numb. Just go and join the party and break it down now.
That's Wonder Woman. She's getting her fortune read, which is, you know, as we all know in the magic community, complete bullshit. What?
You guys are gay.
Why did you say that?
You keep videoing each other.
No, he's videotaping
us. Now I'm going to video Wonder Woman.
Golden Retriever, that's my problem. I don't know where to put him. But I have a little one. They're right there, Yervy.
Hey, take a picture of this one. This chair is kind of cool, though. I want to go get on top of this one.
Iron Man gets Cool Girl. Awesome.
I know. I have to.
We're videotaping this.
Right here. Is it recording?
Yeah.
All right, Wonder Woman and Iron Man.
Videotape this. Iron Man trying to dance.
Yeah. Awesome. Iron Man and Wonder Woman. Yeah. Get a jiggy with it. Get a jiggy with it. Get a jiggy with it. Go, 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 go. Yeah. Awesome. What happened? What happened over there?
You don't hit on your friend, your sister's friend.
What? Come on. It's all good.
This lady said earlier that I need to find a white lady, but now she said no.
Yeah, I know.
Remember?
Yeah, what's up with that? What's up with that? I don't get that.
What's up with that?
Yeah.
Yeah, she's an Iron Man, Iron Blaster blocker.
Yeah.
She blocked me from implanting my fusion on Wonder Woman.
That's your chances, dude!
Yeah! Okay, man, that's
enough.
Right.
Yeah, that's enough.
That's enough.
Whose family's food? Do you understand that?
Whose family?
Well, I'm projecting future.
That was yours, Cynthia?
No.
I don't know.
I don't think you're understanding the scope.
I don't think I'm asking your permission to film you this time, because this is hilarious.
Holding a video camera, but yeah. I don't think you understand.
I want to get your pretty face and all your funny little quips on my video. Okay, don't beat me up. Okay, man, we're winding it down. We're finishing our Doritos. And they're spicy, man. That's right. It's the spice of life. All right, I think Wonder Woman is texting Superman. And that's it. Tony Stark here for the Royal Ramblings, King Vespia. So long.
Is he Ghostbuster Marshmallow? Hold on. Slimer in Marshmallow Man. Did you see him?
Wow. That's cool, man. Yeah. Look at that. I thought the other one. Look at that cat. Jeez.
Look at that. Oh. Awesome.
Ghosts on the roof.
And on Christmas, they do the same thing too. Much even more stuff.
Halloween, everybody. Now, earlier on the video, you saw a scene that I would like to say is a cosplay reenactment, but it's really more closer to the truth than any scene that you've ever seen here on Majestic Memories. And that was the scene where Supergirl comes in and interjects in between myself, the Iron Man, and Wonder Woman while we're dancing. Now, I know it was it made great video, but unfortunately, it's a situation that I have to talk about. You see, for the longest time, Supergirl and I have been very close. In fact, you could almost say that we're like family. And this particular incident was not only embarrassing to me, but it was also embarrassing to Wonder Woman and Spider-Man at the same time. And I'll explain. You see, growing up, I knew Supergirl almost as if she was my sister. And I always tried to take care of her. I always tried to make sure that she was well-fed. I always tried to make sure that she was happy. All the way into adulthood, I was always there for Supergirl. But lately, more and more, Supergirl has become angry with the world, so to speak. And this chip that she's carrying around on her shoulder, I don't know if it's due to losing her family on Krypton, or if it's because she's not getting higher and higher in things that she wants to in life, you know, being on the level of Superman, perhaps. But unfortunately, this anger has begun to affect me in ways that I haven't really had the courage to come out and tell Supergirl face to face. So that's why I'm doing it on a video here for you. You see, Supergirl, I can't understand why it is that you treat everyone like they're below you, and most importantly, myself, as if I don't count, as if I'm to take abuse from you, as if you were like my ex-wife or something to that effect. You always only care about yourself now. I remember the other day we were out and we were getting some documents that we needed, and you totally overlooked me. You didn't even worry about whether or not I had what I needed. And when I asked you what happened, why didn't you help me out in getting what I needed to get, your answer was, well, I don't worry about you. What do I care what you're doing? And you just blew me off. Things like that have been going on our entire lives, Supergirl. I remember one time asking you to borrow some money, and you threw it at me with disdain, disrespecting me when I'm your elder brother. Now, in this particular incident, it was not I that hugged Wonder Woman. She came to me, and I reciprocated the hug. And we were just having a good conversation after a nice dance, and some people might say it was humorous, and maybe you didn't mean much by it, but you interject yourself in between us. You made it look like I was doing something wrong. Later, you verbally said that I had done something wrong, claiming that I had instigated it. You verbally berated Spider-Man off camera, saying that, stop that, don't encourage Iron Man to do such things, when Spider-Man was only doing what he felt natural as a kind, friendly neighborhood Spider-Man, and that was to try to keep Wonder Woman warm after it started to get cold with a little hug of his own, with no malice in his heart, as Spider-Man and Mary Jane are always together. So now he feels bad about that. But you embarrassed me. You embarrassed yourself. And you're probably saying, oh no, you're an idiot, you're wrong, you're stupid. No, you embarrassed yourself behaving like that in front of Wonder Woman. And more importantly, you made me feel terrible. Now, let me ask you something. And a lot of people might concur with this, they might not. What would have been so wrong if Wonder Woman and I actually were getting close? We weren't. You know, I do wish, because she's a very beautiful girl. But obviously, I'm carrying around an iron gut these days, so
you know, better wishes have been made and come true. But the thing is, as my sister, you could have said, oh, you guys like each other? That's great. Or, hey, Iron Man seems to like you, Wonder Woman. Why don't you talk to him a little bit? But if that was too much to ask, how about if you were going to interject yourself in between us, how about doing it to protect me? Not to say, oh, you shouldn't be doing that on camera. You do not flirt with your sister's best friend, as if I was the instigator, as if there was any flirting going on, but not to protect me, because maybe Wonder Woman would hurt me. After all, she was, you know, having a little bit to drink and you know, going around and so forth, not becoming of a lady. But no, instead of blaming her, you blamed me, and then said, oh, haphazardly, you're not supposed to flirt with her, and like I said, off camera, all these vile things. Now, I'm trying to get this off of my chest in the best way that I know how, because right now you're in bed, sound asleep. You're dreaming away the night. You had a great Halloween, and I'm still awake. It's almost 6 o'clock in the morning, and I can't get it out of my head what happened. Yes, I do think that Wonder Woman is very attractive. And yes, you know what terrible things that I've been through in my life, especially with women, are concerned. Maybe you might even encourage it. You did, after all. You told me that I needed to find a white girl like Pepper Potts just minutes before this altercation. Now, all that withstanding, it's not up to you to make up the mind of an adult woman, okay? That's number one. Number two, you're getting to be more and more rude every single day. You know, you think the world revolves around you? Well, it doesn't. And you might be saying, oh, well, like I said, you know, you don't know what you're talking about or whatnot. You're mean. You're a very mean-spirited person. You used to say that I'm mean when we go on vacation. Well, you're mean all the time. You and I are supposed to be a team. But instead, you treat me like I'm one of these people that aren't in your corner. Well, guess what? From now on, it stops. Either we can't communicate anymore, we can't see each other and be a team and be like family, or I'm going to start calling you on it. From now on, you're not going to do that to me anymore. You don't even realize you're doing it anymore because you're so caught up in being coddled and being the baby, your selfishness, that you don't even realize that you make me feel the way that I'm explaining to you that you make me feel. Degraded and scared of you. Scared because your anger is on edge. Now, when you do those kinds of things, I'm going to remind you about it. That night when you stepped in between us, I wanted to walk right out of that party. I wanted to tell each and every one of you, come on, we're going home. Because I was so upset with you. You have no idea. You don't even think about it. Instead, you put the blame on me. Like I said, somehow I did something wrong. Don't you think of me as a good enough person that I wouldn't hurt your friend? In fact, your friend is probably more apt to hurt me, like I said. I don't know. She seems like a very nice girl. But sometimes you gotta wonder about that woman, about all women. And in this case, I'm wondering about you, Supergirl. What happened to you? What happened to us? We were supposed to be like this. You have to try to find that again. And you have to stop berating me. You have to stop thinking of me as, you know, things that I do are stupid. Oh, you said, why don't you become a paparazzi? You're filming her all the time. You better not put that on YouTube. Listen, when I was filming Wonder Woman, as she was flying around outside the party in her invisible jet, and she told me not to film her anymore, I promptly deleted that video. And that also had nothing to do with you. Later on, when her and I were having the conversation about videoing, We were giving each other shit back and forth. That's right. And everything that I just put up on this episode of The Royal Ramblings was okayed by her. She was just explaining how she didn't like me filming the incident out in the street. But I'm tired of explaining myself to you, because I'm not the one to blame here. You are. You need to stop your attitude. It's getting on my nerves. I'm up to here with it now. I put up with it, and I put up with it, and I put up with it to keep the peace. I've said before, like I used to with my old friend the ninja, oh, well, this is just the way you are. Well, if this is just the way you are, then it's wrong. You've got a bad seed. It's like a disease. And Supergirl, you wonder why you can't find your Superman? Well, maybe. Just maybe. If you look deep inside or look in the mirror, you'll realize that that attitude, that gruffness, that meanness, that self-centeredness might just be the reason.